Hello everyone, this is the third session on chapter pricing and marketing. In this session, I'll discuss two topics. Number one is approaches to price adjustment. Then second is effect of price changes. These two topics I'll discuss in this session. So in the approaches to price adjustment, we'll go through some approaches through which marketer bring adjustment to their existing prices. Now first approach to price adjustment is geographical pricing. In geographical pricing, when a company sells its product to customer spread over a diverse geographical region, it adopts geographical pricing policy. According to this approach, companies set different price for customers situated at different geographical location to adequately cover their delivery expenses. Geographical pricing can be set by adopting uniform delivery pricing. And uniform delivery pricing refers to companies fixing a uniform price for the entire market. What I said, uniform delivery pricing refers to companies and price fixing as uniform price for the entire market. Then second pricing policy company may follow FOB pricing. FOB pricing refers to fee on board. Fee on board, or in fee on board, customer bear the transportation cost of the goods being delivered. In the FOB pricing, what happens? Customer bear the transportation cost of goods being delivered. Then third is zone pricing. In zone pricing, marketer divide the target market into different zone depending on population density and transportation convenience. Then number four is basis point pricing. Basis point pricing, or in basis point pricing, company fixed certain locations and they call this as basis point, and goods dispatched from this same basis point are priced the same. So simply, certain location are called as basis point, the goods dispatched from the same basis point are priced the same. So finally, in geographical pricing, we have seen that company can set the price or bring adjustment to their price in four ways. These are uniform delivery pricing, then FOB pricing, zone pricing, and basis point pricing. Next, we'll move to the promotional pricing. Sometimes marketers price their product below the list price in a bid to attract large number of customers. However, this approach is only a short-term approach and may have negative results if adopted in the long term. The next is discriminatory pricing. According to this approach, marketer change different price from different customers for the same product. The basis for discrimination can be in the form of paying capacity of the customer, value attached to the consumer by marketer, etc. Then next is discounts and allowances. Marketer may also offer discount and allowances on the price of product to attract customers. The following are some of the types of discount and allowances adopted by companies, like seasonal discount, cash discount, quantity discount, trade discount. Like this discount company may offer to the customers. Then next is experience curve pricing. In the experience curve pricing, while introducing a new product in the market, companies offer the product at low price with a view to attract the price sensitive customers. This is generally done by companies assuming that the cost of production would come down as the worker get used to the production process, and as a result of their experience, productivity goes up. Thus, the initial low price of the product can be set off by the large volume of output produced and sold in due course of time. Now, in the experience curve pricing, moreover, we can say that when company introduce a product in the market, company set the price of the product low with the assumption that when in the production field people were employees were producing the product, they will gather experience, and due to that experience they can produce more products in less time, and that will recover the production cost. Or in a service industry, like as employee gather experience, they can give more service delivery with minimum time, and that may reduce the service delivery cost. So this is basically the concept behind the experience curve pricing. Then next is product mix pricing. In the product mix pricing, we'll discuss it elaborately. The various method of setting product mix pricing are there, and first is product line pricing. What I said, I repeat, in the product mix pricing there are various method of setting products are there, and among them one is product line pricing. Marketer with more than one product item in a product line generally fix price for products line instead of individual product. In this method, the sales of one product in the product line may influence the sale of other. It is therefore important for the marketers to understand the interrelationship between different items in the product line. Then second product mix pricing method is optional feature pricing. According to this approach, marketers set up a price for the basic product, and additional charges need to be paid for optional features. Thus, the price of the product varies according to the optional features present in the product. For example, any personal car manufacturers, the basic car is priced differently. Now, optional features like air conditioner, power window, power steering are priced differently. The car is priced differently, and these features like air conditioner, power window, power steering, these are priced differently or separately. Then we can say that there are basic product and optional features in the product. A company will charge a price for the basic products and there will be additional price for the optional features associated with that product. The next is captive product pricing. Marketer price the spare parts or ancillary parts relatively higher than the basic product in order to overcome the low profit share earned through the sale of the basic product. For instance, films used in camera, blades for razors, cartridges for printers, then refill for ball pen are generally priced higher. Next, in the product mix pricing, two-part pricing. In this method of pricing, marketer charged a fixed price for an initial service and subsequent charges for over and above the minimum service provided. Like mobile service provider companies, they have fixed price for certain basic service and additional service charges are also there, or we can say like in the telecom service industry, postpaid scheme are there. In the postpaid scheme, a customer need to give a minimum fixed rental. Then after that, there is additional charges if customer avail additional service. So this kind of pricing is known as two-part pricing. Then next is by-product pricing. Price setting of product obtained from an original product is known as by-product pricing. I repeat, price setting of product obtained from an original product is known as by-product pricing. Pricing of products such as diesel, kerosene, and other petroleum products is done using the by-product pricing approach. Then in the product mix pricing, last pricing method is product bundling pricing. In this method, marketer offers a group of selected or related products at an attractive price. For instance, computer manufacturer offers software along with the software, then scanner machine, printer, along with the computers, with a in a package. So this kind of pricing is known as product bundling pricing. So this was basically about the approaches to price adjustment. Here we have discussed geographical pricing, promotional pricing, discriminatory pricing, discount and allowances, then experience curve pricing and product mix pricing. In product mix pricing, we have discussed pricing method like product line pricing, optional feature pricing, captive product pricing, two-part pricing, by-product pricing, product bundling pricing. This is about the geographical pricing, like FOB. Again, repeating geographical pricing, like free on board, which I said earlier, origin pricing, then uniform delivery pricing, zone pricing, basis point pricing, then freight absorption pricing. This is another pricing method. Now these are some detail about the different geographical pricing. FOB ordering pricing. The buyers absorb the freight cost from the shipping point, fee on board. Uniform delivery pricing. The seller pays the freight charge and bills the purchaser and identical flat freight charges. Zone pricing. Like here we are giving an example, like US is divided into different zone, and a flat freight rate is charged to customer in a given zone. Then freight absorption pricing. The seller pays for all or part of the freight charges and does not pass them on to the buyers. And basis point pricing. The seller designates a location as basis point and charges all buyers the freight cost from that point. Then promotional pricing. Yeah, these are also some literature on promotional pricing. Special event pricing, cash rebates, low interest financing, lower payment terms, then warranties and service contracts, psychological discounting, then discriminatory pricing. It can be based on discrimination, can be based on customer segment like upper class, middle class and lower class segment of the customers, like Tata Motors. They have introduced Tata Nano for the one segment of customer. Then they have costly car for upper class and middle class also. Then product form based on product form also price can be discriminate, like soap, any soap is available in liquid soap. Then location, based on the location price can be different. Then time, like during the summer season price is differently charged, and during winter season, like for woolen goods, then cold drinks, AC machines, air cooler, this can be priced differently in different season. The next, discount and allowances. Cash discount, quantity discount, functional discount, seasonal discount, and finally allowances. Then experience curve pricing. Company introduced the product with low price with the assumption that as employees will gather experience, they will produce more and company can recover the production cost. Then product mix pricing. In the product mix pricing, all these methods we have discussed. Again, I am repeating. Product line pricing, optional product pricing, captive product pricing, by product pricing, two-part pricing, product bundling pricing. Now, if you think that any one of these methods you are not getting, so you can go back to the lecture part where I have given the explanation. So this is basically the part where you can think that what is product line pricing, what is optional product pricing. So you can think like, and you can shape up your answer, and if you are not able to do it, you can go back and you can see the explanation given there. And the last part is effect of price changes. Now, effect of price changes, sometimes certain factors force marketers to increase or decrease the price of their product or services. In such cases, the perception of buyers and competitors' reaction influences the decision of price change to large extent. Now we'll go through the buyer perception on the price change. In situation when marketers are left with no other opportunity but to increase the price, they are obligated to communicate the reason that led to the price change to the customers. This is essential because consumers are very price sensitive for certain products, and the marketer may as well lose customers' loyalty on account of price change. And here, if marketer change the price, marketer increase price or decrease price, the reaction of the buyers or how buyers perceive the change in price, marketer need to do the study. Otherwise, in the long run, company may incur loss. Then next is competitor's reaction. Competitor reaction to price change. Marketer must undertake price changes by anticipating the competitor's reaction to such change. Competitor's reaction may be anticipated by observing the past reaction of competitors. Marketer should also constantly keep track of the competitors' moves, their strategies, etc. Such knowledge would help companies in formulating the right pricing policy for their product or services. So in the effect of price change, there are two areas: buyer perception on price change and competitors' reaction. So in the buyer perception, how customers are perceiving the price changes that company need to take care, and in the competitors' reaction, how competitors are reacting on the price changes. This marketer need to understand observing the market movements. So here we are basically ending the chapter discussion on the pricing and marketing area. And again, I'm saying that to cover the chapter pricing and marketing, I have taken 3 sessions. And this is the last session. And thank you, everybody. Thank you very much. But before leaving the session, I would like to give the summary of the chapter of pricing and marketing. From this chapter, I have covered concept of price, price and non-price competition, the process of setting price, approaches to price adjustment, effect of price changes. Now, I would like to also advise to all of you that you recommend the channel and lecture videos to others also. Thank you again.